Hi, I'm Jessi. I've shown horses my entire life and I typically judge 10 to 15 shows a year. While the quality horse and rider combination normally go home at the end of the day with the blue ribbon, a fat, shiny horse always gets noticed. Today I'm going to share some tips with you on how to achieve more shine and bloom to your horse's coat for an overall healthier appearance. Our model today is Skipper, a 10-year-old thoroughbred gelding who shows in the Children's Hunters. When grooming, it's most important to start with the feet. A horse cannot cover the ground adequately if there is debris up in the sole. Picking out the feet allows you a chance to clear any mud or debris away from the sole. It also gives you a chance to check on the quality of your horse's shoes and nails. I prefer to use a hoof pick that has a hard brush on the outside in order to clean mud off the hoof wall. Next, I like to curry the horse all the way from the tip of its muzzle back to its rump. Currying gives you a chance to loosen up all the dead hair and dirt that's accumulated since the last grooming. It also gives you a good chance to check for any cuts or scrapes that your horse may have got since the last time you groomed it. I prefer to use a rubber grooming mitt like this one because you can use it on the legs as well as on the face. It conforms to all the contours of the horse's body. After all the dirt and loose hair has been curried to the top of the horse's coat, I like to use a vacuum to remove it. If you don't have access to a horse vac, a medium or stiff bristled brush would work just fine. The reason I like using a horse vac is you know that the dead hair and dirt is getting removed from the body. Sometimes, when you're using a brush, it just transfers the dirt from one part of the body to another. Now that we've finished vacuuming, the next thing we're going to do is use a nice soft finishing brush over the horse's entire body to give it a bit of shine. Horses also love how these soft brushes feel on their face. Always brush your horse's coat in the direction in which the hair is growing. As I said earlier, horses really enjoy having their faces brushed with these soft brushes. Next, I'll show you how to take care of your horse's mane and tail. Next, we're going to work on the tail. I like to apply a generous amount of show sheen to the bottom of the horse's tail to assist with detangling and conditioning. A good quality tail brush is a great investment. Always hold the horse's tail hair with one hand while you brush with the other hand. This prevents breakage. A note about show sheen, never put it on the horse's body or in the mane. If you put it on the horse's body, your saddle will have a very hard time staying in place, and using show sheen in the mane will make it impossible to braid the mane. Let's move on to the mane. There's nothing more beautiful than a properly pulled mane. In order to have nice looking bands and braids at a show, your horse needs to have a properly pulled mane. Some horses don't care to have their mane pulled, but if you develop a proper and quick technique, you can make the whole situation a lot less painful for both you and your horse. If your horse has a thin mane, you can use an old clipper blade to shorten it since there won't be anything to pull. However, if your horse has a thick mane, never, ever, ever cut it. The only way to solve that problem is by pulling. Next, we'll move on to clipping the horse's muzzle, ears, bridle path, and legs. Trimming up your horse's face and legs really tidies up the overall appearance. I like to start with the muzzle. Most horses are really good about this. It doesn't hurt them at all. Then I move to the jawline. we'll go up to the bridle path. And we'll finish out the face by clipping out their ears. The most common size blade to use when trimming the face is a size 10 blade. You may also choose to use a size 40 blade on the ears if you want a very close cut. Lastly, we'll finish up by doing some trim work on the legs. I like to clip the coronet band and up the backs of the legs to give a nice, fresh, clean cut. Now let's add some fly spray and coat conditioner. Now we'll begin some of our finishing touches. In the summertime, you'll obviously want to use a good fly spray, and I like to use a coat conditioner all year long. To kill two birds with one stone, you can do both of these steps simultaneously. A coat conditioner is good because it provides sunscreens for your horse when he's out all day. Always make sure to apply fly spray to the legs and underneath the belly. The next step is we'll apply some baby oil to the horse's ears and muzzle. Now we're going to add some baby oil to the muzzle and ears for an extra level of shine. And now it's time for the most important finishing touch, hoof polish. And for being such a great model today, we're going to give Skipper a treat. Thank you, Skipper.